I have a MacBook Pro with Apple Silicon here. In this video, I'll show you how to set up your Mac so you can run TensorFlow in it and take advantage of your GPU. So I have the instructions here and I'll post the link in the description below in case you want to follow along. The first step is to install Homebrew. Now I already have Homebrew on my computer, so I won't do that. But if you click on the link that I have there in the instructions, you'll see they give you a long command here. The only thing you need to do is just copy that command, paste it on your terminal window, and that will install Homebrew for you. The second step is to download and install Miniforge. Again, I already have that done. I added here the three commands that you need to do that. The first after you download Miniforge from the link will be changing the permissions so you can actually execute that script, executing the script, and then activating Miniforge. Make sure when you do this, however, that you restore your terminal. So that's important. If you don't restore your terminal, commands after that one may fail. Step number four, this is what I'm going to start doing it here on screen. This is to create a conda environment. Now, personally, I'm gonna be using Python 3.8. You can be using Python 3.9 or Python 3.10 as well. So I'm gonna go here, and actually before I execute that, I have a specific folder where I'm gonna be creating that. So I'm gonna go to that folder and then create my conda environment. That will take a second to complete. Okay, so now I can activate that conda environment. There we go. The fifth step is to install TensorFlow and all of the dependencies that we need. Let's start by installing TensorFlow dependencies. Okay. Then we can install TensorFlow Metal. Then we're gonna install the TensorFlow port, the Apple port of the TensorFlow library. It usually takes a minute to install. There we go. Finally, we can install using conda any libraries that you want to use, that you want to activate on that as part of that environment. In my case here, I'm gonna install Jupyter, NumPy, and Matplotlib. Now that that's done, the next step is to run Jupyter. This is the way you run it. I'm just gonna call Jupyter Notebook. That will open, automatically will open a notebook here on my browser. Now, I don't want to use this notebook here. Instead, what I want to do is connect my Visual Studio code to this Jupyter server and use my notebook or write my code from Visual Studio code. In order to do that, I'm going to go here to my terminal and you'll see that we have a URL. I'm gonna go to Visual Studio code and I'm gonna open the notebook that I want to make changes to. So this is the notebook, very simple notebook. I'm importing TensorFlow. I'm printing out the list of physical devices that TensorFlow has access to. And what we want to see when we do that, we want to see a GPU as part of one of those devices. So in order to run this using the server, the Jupyter server that is running on my computer, I need to make sure that down here says Jupyter server remote. You want to click there and make sure you paste the URL that you want to connect to. So I'm gonna do that right now. After you do that, this here tells you what is the kernel that you're using. So click there and make sure you select the kernel that you just installed using conda, the environment. So I'm gonna connect to that kernel there, and when that's done, I can run the cell of the notebook. It's gonna take a second. If everything goes well, I should see the list of devices. In this case, you'll see that right now, we have access to the GPU here on my Apple M1 Mac, and that's what we want. I'm doing this so I can run Stable Diffusion here on my computer with access to GPU. That video will go up a few days after this one, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss it. Go nuts, build something cool, and I'll see you in the next one.